He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Let's try a practice problem regarding enthalpy of vaporization. So the question is, how much heat is required to vaporize 1.500 liters of water at 37 degrees Celsius? So in order to answer this, we need to know that the density of water at 37 degrees Celsius is actually just a hair under 1 gram per milliliter, which is what we're used to. We're going to use 0.9934 grams per milliliter to be very specific. And then the heat of vaporization of water at 37 degrees Celsius is 43.46 kilojoules per mole. So this is all the data you need to answer this question. Go ahead and give it a try. So let's take our 1.500 liters of water, and we're going to want to do some stoichiometric calculations. So we've got to get to moles. Our goal is always going to be to get to moles somehow with these things. So let's take our 1.500 liters, and we want milliliters because our density was grams per milliliter. So let's multiply by 1,000 milliliters over 1 liter, and we're going to get 1,500 milliliters. Now that we have milliliters, we can use our density, 1,500 milliliters times 0.9934 grams per milliliter, and that is going to give us a mass of 1,490 grams. So that is the mass of water contained in that volume of water, specifically at this temperature, 37 degrees Celsius, right? If we had a different temperature, things might be slightly different. Then we take our 1490 grams of water and we're going to multiply by 1 mole over 18.02 grams. That's the molar mass of water. And we know we therefore have 82.69 moles of water. That's how many moles of water are in this volume of water at this temperature. Then lastly, we can just use the given thermochemical data. We know that 82.69 moles times 43.46 kilojoules of energy required per mole for vaporization to occur, that's going to give us a total of 3,594 kilojoules of energy required to vaporize this volume of water at this temperature.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.